Namaste. So today we are going to talk about spirituality versus religion. What I have learned from my masters is spirituality is something which is applied to any human being born on this planet. Religion is divisive. It divides people. It says that you are of this religion, I am of that religion. So it divides people. That is not what spirituality is. Any human being born on this planet Earth is governed by the universal laws or the universal energies, which we call God per se. I personally don't like to use the word God, only because I feel God, when you say God, then my God is different, your God is different. So again, it divides. So I would like to use the word cosmic energy or universal energy. In case, whenever I speak, I say use the word God, please remember I'm only referring to the universal energies which is applicable to any human being born on this universe. As opposed to religion, each religion has its own binding. Certain things are correct to one religion that is exactly opposite of the other religion. I would give an example. Like in Christianity, we wear our shoes and go to the church. But when we go to a temple or a gurudwara, we have to leave our shoes or footwear outside. In a church, you can even go without a bath, but in Hindu temples, oh my God, you can't go without a bath. So what is good for one religion is exactly the opposite of the other religion, which is something which I do not agree with. Spirituality means it has to apply to any human being born on this planet. It has to be equal law for all. Because God per se, nobody knows. It's the cosmic energy, the divine energy. And that divine energy has not made such rules and regulations for every human being. Something that is good for you, if it is bad for me, then that is not applicable to me. For example, again, coming back to Christianity, even women, when they have their menstrual cycle, they're not allowed to go to the church in a Hindu temple. But in Christianity, it is allowed. Hindus make a big hoo-ha about it, or many other religions make a hoo-ha about it. But in Christianity, it is fine. So if it is applicable or allowed to one God, it has to be allowed by the other God, because God per se is one universal energy. Again, in religion, it binds you by doing certain japas, certain mantras, certain fasts are done on certain days. All these things bind you with religion. Spirituality has no such binding. You do not have to do all these things at all. No naam jap, no fasting, no nothing applies to spirituality. Again, religion is power based. I feel religion people use to bribe the gods. So many a times these mannats or these offerings are done in temples or gurudwaras or any other religious activity, saying that, okay, please do this for me, I'll offer this to you. It is a man-made thing. Religion is man-made. Spirituality is God-made. It's not man-made. So when it is man-made, then there are restrictions. And I personally do not believe something that is man-made, because then the power influences those activities a lot. It's fear-based. Religion is fear-based. Lot of us get scared of certain things. Oh, no, no, no. My God will get angry if I do this. Oh, no, no, no. My God will get angry if I eat non-vegetarian or if I have a small drink. When it comes to spirituality, everything is equal and uniform to every human being. This is the mistake we people do about spirituality and religion, and that is why people get scared of spirituality, because they feel that, oh, now they are going to bind me with these things. With religion, you have to wear these kind of clothes, you have to do these kind of things, or don't do these kind of things. Such bindings are not there. It is, I would say, it's applied spirituality. Whatever is good for you, whatever you're comfortable in, you do, and that is spirituality. Religion does not say so. Religion is more binding, constructing, more restricting. So that is the main difference between spirituality and religion. So, my dear friends, I would advise you to be spiritual and not religious. But if you're following any religion and if you're happy with it, if you're getting those comforts from within, please continue. Don't misunderstand me. What I mean is don't do it. What I mean is something that pleases your heart, something that transforms you, something that makes you feel nice, continue doing it. Do not discontinue whatever practices you are doing. That's not what I mean. But it does not have to be binding on you. If something which is binding on you and if you're not happy doing it, then that means it is religiously bound. That is not spirituality. So don't do anything that is binding, which is restricting your growth. That is the difference between spirituality and religion. Thank you.